When modeling a motorcycle rear tire, a couple of dimensions we have to take into consideration. We've got the diameter, the overall diameter of the rim. So that's going to be the smallest part of the tire right here. And then we've got the edge of the tire right here. And then of course you have the furthest edge. A motorcycle tire is a lot different to a car tire. Car tires are very flat, motorcycle tires very rounded. It's almost like a perfect curve because, you know, you want to be able to transition smoothly from one angle of lean to another. So that's the first mistake a lot of people make when modeling a motorcycle tire. It's got to be completely curved. The other mistake a lot of people make is that they don't make this edge here sharp enough. On a real motorcycle tire, this edge is as sharp as this. It's a perfect sharp edge. I mean, this inner part here is actually slightly concave. But, you know, we don't need to show that in this kind of detail level of a 3D model. So, we start with the rim diameter. The rim diameter is typically about 17 inches. Certain bikes have an 18-inch rear rim, but most bikes have 17-inch rims front and back. So, what I'm going to do is I created a cylinder. And the cylinder here, I'm going to give it one height segment oriented on the x-axis so it points towards me, and I'm going to turn the caps off. We don't need those. The rotation segments is really up to you. I mean, that's just how detailed you want your tire, I guess. I'll go at 40 for now. So then I can make it editable. I'll just press the C key and then I scale it up here till it just fits the inside. You know, there's always distortion in photographs, so you can never get it perfect, but just try to get it to fit as nicely as you can. So there we have the inside of our tire. We look at it in 3D, it's way off. We need to figure out what's the width there. Now that width is determined by the rim. However wide your rim is at this point is however wide that point of your tire is going to be. So, let's turn to the internet. This website is motorbikes.be. I really like this website. It gives you specs, all the specs on all the bikes. So I just searched for the 999 Ducati. I'll go with the 2005 model. And we've got all these stats. Now right down here, you can see that the rear wheel is 5.5 inches by 17 inches. So that's it. We need to be 5.5 inches. So whatever kind of units you're working in, you know, just make the X width 5.5. So for me, that'd be 55. So I work in at a multiple of 10. Everything in my Cinema 40 is in inches, but it's 10 times the size it should be. I just feel comfortable working in that system. So now we have the correct width for our rear rim. It's 55 inches by 17. Or rather, not the rear rim, but the area of the tire where that's going to happen. So, now we need to bring out two edges here so that we can get this other edge here. Easiest way to do that I found is just to select all the polygons and extrude them. That's it. Whether you want the create caps option or on or off, it's really up to you. I'm going to go back to my side view and we see that, hey, I almost got it the exact amount it was supposed to be. But if you don't, you know, just scale it. You can scale it here really easily until it fits there. Now, how wide is this? Now here's where reading the tire size the bike comes in really handy. This bike comes with a rear wheel 5.5 by 17 and a rear tire of 190 millimeters by 50 on a 17-inch rim. So we've got 190 millimeters should be the width of that area. That says the widest area of the tire when it's on the bike, which would be this. 190 millimeters would be 7.48 inches. So For me, that's 74.8. So right away, just from a 5.5 inch width and our 190 millimeters, we now have this edge of the tire accurately. That's how it's supposed to look. So now we've got the curve there of the tire to do. And that's the easy part. We just extrude once more until we've hit the outside of the tire, because that's now the widest part of the part of the tire that's the most pronounced. Now, here's how I like to do this. I like to scale the polygons along the x-axis inwards until we got something looking like that. So we can already see the tire taking shape, but we need to add a loop of edges here and a loop of edges here. We can just use the knife tool in loop mode. While you're sliding it back and forth along an edge, if you tap shift and release, it locks it, enabling you to numerically change the cut. So we want the cut at 50% exactly, and we just click to make the cut. Do the same thing over here, 50% cut. Now we can use the loop selection to select these two loops of edges, and we scale them up. Now we want to scale them up only along the Y and Z, not along the X. So we hover over the X axis, hold shift and click, and we release shift and we can drag. So there we go, that's it. We just scale along the X and along the Y and Z until it looks good. I'm just gonna make my strip of polygons in the center a little wider. I'm gonna flatten out the tire a little bit. So once you get that rim width and your back tire width, it's cool. It's fine.